want to get your take on the labour skills that are currently needed in the US for this manufacturing pivot. If we were to bring iPhone manufacturing to the United States, could we do it in a near enough time frame?
It will take years to develop the talent base needed to bring a lot of advanced manufacturing back to the United States. I think there's a certain logic to making sure that advanced manufacturing is under the control of the US and our allies. And that's important, not just us, but also our trusted allies. Several years ago, I actually visited Wisconsin, where the first Trump administration and Foxconn had mightily put effort into Wisconn Valley, which is an attempt to move display manufacturing, panel display manufacturing to the United States in Wisconsin. And frankly, it was a great effort, but it really struggled to gain traction because it's very difficult to find the talent in Wisconsin or in the US more broadly with the advanced manufacturing skills. Manufacturing today is often a high skill requiring knowing about robotics, knowing about software. It's not just people assembling little things with their hands anymore. And we've got a lot of work to do to grow that talent in the US.
Where could we bring in from? Andrew, where have you seen that skill set among allies that can be brought in? Because in many ways, it's feeling as though we're not bringing in talent from abroad at this moment either.
I think that in the case of manufacturing talent, clearly China has a lot of it. I think Taiwan, interestingly, also has a lot of manufacturing talent. So I feel like, and obviously also Japan, I think some parts of Korea as well, especially when it comes to semiconductors. But so many of our allies do have skilled manufacturing talent, but how to work with them to import some of those skills to the US is, I think, something still to be figured out. And then on the other end of the spectrum that you alluded to, I think one of the best things the US could do to ensure American competitiveness in AI and other advanced technology fields is to, frankly, support our universities and support high-skill immigration.
How have you been considering the cuts to science funding in particular? Is that impacting your sector, the sector you want to invest more in with your second fund?
So AI Fund's Venture Studio, we work with many entrepreneurs to build companies. And I feel like over the last many decades, America led the world in science and technology. And this was an era when we have strong institutions like the National Science Foundation and the NIH that funded open research. One thing that I think not many people fully understand is when, say, the National Science Foundation funds a researcher, they write a research paper that's published for free, anyone on the internet can read it. Yes, it helps our adversaries. Yes, it helps the whole world. But the country it helps the most is America. Because when an American researcher on American soil publishes a paper, that diffusion of knowledge is fastest within America. And yes, other countries, including our adversaries, can benefit from it too. But that openness of research helps the country that does it the most. And so I think America's ability to attract amazing international... I was once an international student myself on an F1 visa, and I came to the US to study and I ended up staying and hopefully making some positive contributions to this country. I think welcoming school immigration would be an important piece of ensuring American competitiveness.
Well, let's talk about your positive contribution when it comes to raising $190 million second fund to invest in AI talent and startups and sort of co-found them in many ways. What sectors are you looking at, and are they US-built companies alone?
We are building, the majority of companies we build are in the US, but we are also working with businesses in Japan, Taiwan, Korea, and so on. AI Fund's a venture studio. So what I decided was, unlike a traditional VC, you know, I don't want to be competing for or chasing deal flow. So we exclusively work with entrepreneurs to co-found companies. What that means is my team is alongside the entrepreneur. We're writing code, talking to customers, debating what features to build. And because my team is fortunate to be close to the AI technology, it lets us look across many different industry sectors, recruit great AI talent, and apply our technical expertise to all sorts of different sectors where AI can be applied.